You might think, what is おもてなし? These days, the word おもてなし is being used by the media a lot more to promote Japanese hospitality. Because of the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. In Japan, there is a proverb, お客様は神様。It can be translated to the customer is always right. But most Japanese probably think of the literal translation, which is the customer is good. Does おもてなし mean being obsequious to customers? Let's see. The original word for おもてなしis もてなし。ジオ is added to show politeness. According to Japanese dictionaries, today, おもてなし has multiple meanings, such as treatment, feast, entertainment towards guests or customers. However, the first things that comes to our mind,When hearing this word, is a heartfelt customer service in a hotel, shop, or a restaurant. The word もてなし originates with the traditional Japanese tea ceremony in 12th century. Originally, there were two meanings. The first one was achieve somethingby using all the things you have. These things include abstract ideas you cannot see, such as attentiveness or kindness towards other people. The second meaning was no front or back. In Japanese, omote means front.Nashi means absence. If something has no front, it automatically has no back. Therefore, it is understood as welcoming a guest with an open and sincere mind. The person who most influences the basic meaning of omotenashi is Sennorikyu.The historical figure most closely associated with 茶の湯, which means the way of tea or tea ceremony. In particular, the tradition of wabicha in 16th century. Wabicha is a style of Japanese tea ceremony particularly associated with 千の利休, 竹の蝶,and its originator, Murata Juko. Wabicha emphasizes simplicity. Wabicha masters concerned the purpose of making a bowl of Japanese green tea as a mental training. From the outset, the tea ceremony was used to spread Zen philosophy amongst social elites.However, within 300 years, it became a competitive way to show off expensive and luxurious tea utensils. Wabicha masters strongly criticized these ostentatious tea ceremonies and sought to restore Zen philosophy into the way of tea. They used simpleinexpensive utensils. Rikyu left behind a famous phrase among Japanese tea masters. 茶はカツを椅子のに止まる which means the tea ceremony is just for quenching thirst. Of course, it has deeper meaning, as we'll see. Rikyu's most famous principle, 一子知足。This means seven rules. Regarding the correct mindset to welcome guests in the tea room. In a nutshell, 1. Speculate carefully about the guest's feelings based on the context. 2. Make sufficient preparation. 3. Know the essence of beauty and decorate simply. 4. Be flexible and exercise ingenuity. 5. Find a way to remain calm. 6. Prepare for the worries of all guests. 7. Be respectful and considerate towards each other. To recap, もてなし meant how you make guests feel. Thus, 茶はカツを椅子るに止まる。Men the tea ceremonies are for enriching people's hearts. I'll introduce Senrikyu's knife in my next video and chart his rise from a fishmonger's son to a tea master and advisor for military dictators over two generations. If you are interested in the background to this success story, don't miss it.Now let's look at the difference between social graces, service, hospitality and omotenashi. Social graces or social form generally means the ability to fit into polite society and behave properly by following established etiquette. The number one priorityis not to make the other people feel uncomfortable. Moving on to service. Dictionaries define a service as the action of doing something for someone or something. It's largely intangible. A service tends to be an experience that is consumed at the point where it is purchased.As you can see, there is very clear line between person who receives a service, customer, and person who provides it, server. You need to pay to receive services. Thus, the relationship between those two people often takes on the dynamic of master and servant.Services can also be provided anytime, anywhere, to anyone. Although, today, the word hospitality is often used in business. The original meanings has nothing to do with making money. The etymology of hospitality is a Latin hospes, which meanshost, guest, or stranger. In ancient cultures, hospitality sometimes meant welcoming a stranger and offering him food, shelter, and safety. This implies hospitality is not an action motivated by command, obligation,a sort of reward. It stems from people's good intentions. Hospitality is a special kindness. At this time, in this place, only for this person. It stands for mutual respect between the host and their guests. In business,Hospitality has come to mean providing individual tailored services to customers from the heart. And it tends to be concerned with voluntary acts that don't require any additional reward. In Japan, tipping is unheard of. The meaning of hospitality and omotenashi are very similar. Although there are slight differences in nuance due to differences in Western Japanese culture, you probably already realized the answer to the question at the beginning of this video. Does being obsequious to customers mean omotenashi? Absolutely not. As we've just seen, originally, omotenashi is referred to an equal, mutually respectful, pointedly non-commercial relationship between a tea master and a guest. Services are not. Unfortunately, Japan ranks pretty low in the world when it comes to treating hospitality staff with polite respect. The shock was no surprise when customers are routinely treated like gods. As in many other countries, work pressure has been mounting in Japan. On top of that, there is a social pressure of a hierarchical society that is still rooted in a village mindset. Perhaps you can imagine how difficult it is to work for such long hours every day with very little authority or permission to speak up. As a result, people have very little headspace for strangers and assume they have a right to be rude to servants for a little while. At the end of the day, the people who actually serve customers, such as waiters and shopkeepers, have a huge impact on feelings of customer satisfaction. However, most people in the service sector are working very hard for very little money. Many of them are part-timers with no proper benefits or job security. Therefore, some people need two or three jobs to survive. They are called fritters, which means casual workers. It would be very important that employers show employees how they respect them. A little more job security and some discretionary power could go a long way towards providing even better services that genuinely capture the spirit of omotenashi, rather than obsequiousness of desperation. Nowadays, because of coronavirus, people's perspectives and sense of value appears to be changing. For the moment, people are generally more appreciative of frontline staff, particularly essential workers. Rikyu said, Ichigo-ichie, which is a Japanese four-character idiom that encourages us to treasure the unrepeatable nature of a moment. The term has been translated as for this time only and once in a lifetime. If we interact with other people as if it's always the last time we'll meet them, perhaps we'll all find the motivation to be a bit kinder and nicer to others. In many cases, I fear the opposite would be true. Why invest effort in being kind to someone you'll never see again? for me, that begs the question. Whether Ricky's innate optimism helped him to rise from humble beings to elite advisor, or whether his good fortune fueled his optimism. We'll find out next time.